Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Sydney, Australia, here at the Sydney International Shooting Centre, where the weather is unseasonably cold and rainy. We're here for the first final of the day, 50-metre pistol men, and I'm Hilary Russell. I have the pleasure of having Italy's 2010 World Cup final gold medalist and two-time World Cup gold medalist Mauro Bariacchi with me today. Welcome, Mauro, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Hi, everybody.
Just the other day, we had a chance to have an interview with you, and you discussed this discipline. So let's take a look at the interview.
50-meter pistol is, we have almost the same technique about of 10 meters, mm-hmm. but of course it's much more harder because the distance is five more times about of air pistol. And it's very good discipline. Maybe it's of course harder, but I like it very much mm-hmm. Because when you shoot a 10, is you know, you feel like a good shooter, and the technique is the same. And we shoot with the caliber 22, mm-hmm. and the pistol is called a free pistol because you can use. Your grip without laws, without rules. Mm-hmm. The only rules is that you can move your
wrist.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And there is one big long barrel, a mm-hmm. Little bit longer than air pistol, and to make a lot precision of your shot. It's hard when you shoot with the wind and you have to take look of the light mm-hmm. and because shooting in outside is of course much more difficult because you have to see all these kind of problems.
Mm-hmm. That was a great interview, Mauro. Thank you for your words describing this discipline. Like I was saying before, it is cold out here, and we can certainly feel it here in the finals hall. How was it during qualifications today?
Yes, it was a little bit cold, not so much, and also not so windy. Mm-hmm. But of course, in 8 in the morning, it's not so easy to shoot. But we have 8 great shooters today that they made a very good job.
Yeah. They certainly did.
Yeah. And let's see what happened.
As you can see, it's 17 degrees Celsius. So I was speaking to one of the shotgun shooters, Russell Mark, from Australia this morning. He said, you're just not here for the right weather. Usually it's not this cold.
Yes.
Hey, here we have a great turnout of the ISSF VIPs. We have President Mr. Vasquez Rania and his wife, Elita. And we also had a picture there of Vice President, Mr. Gary Anderson. Got quite a full house here today for this final. It's been like this all week. And it's nice having a combined World Cup. In that case, we can have, you know, see so many different shooters. And it was nice yesterday also because the shotgun shooters came over to watch one of the finals here in the finals hall for rifle and pistol. So that was really great. Tell me a little bit about what you've been doing for training.
I usually train 6 times per week, mm-hmm. 6 days, and sometimes I made two times per day.
Wow.
Yeah, sometimes. And I had a little bit problem since January because I had a problem with my arm, mm-hmm. and so I had no volume of training. Much volume of training, and we are trying to to take this in each competition, and we will stay here until 6th of April.
Okay.
And then we go directly to Korea, mm-hmm. and I hope in these days to make a nice training.
Yeah.
Because I feel that I need a little bit more.
You were saying during qualification today that your arm was just moving a little bit up
yes.
or down. Yeah.
Yes, a little bit. And also I had a problem with, I was sick mm-hmm. in these days. And I took some antibiotic before
boy.
The competition. So
that's not so great.
Yeah, because of my throat and I had a fever 3 days ago. Mm-hmm. And so I'm not lucky this year, but
hopefully your luck will turn around.
Yes.
Here we have the Secretary General, Mr. Franz Schreiber. on the screen right now. And we're just looking at the record holders. It was from the former Soviet Union. The score was 581 points for the world record. And the final world record was set by the USA Demarest, and that was 676.2 points. There are two quota places that are up for grabs today. And only three of the finalists, well, you can see the finalists on the screen right now. Only Wu from China, Bruno, your teammate, from Italy, and Pang from China are up for the quota places, because all the other shooters have either gained a quota place for their country in this event or in another event if they shoot two different types of disciplines. So in just a second here, I'm going to introduce the finalists, and here we go. In eighth place, with 559 points, representing Turkey, we have Yusuf Dikac. He's 38 years old. He placed sixth in Munich in 2008 during the World Cup, and he also placed ninth in Munich during the World Cup in 2008. In seventh place today, coming with 560 points, representing Serbia, we have Damir Mikic. He's 26 years old. He won the silver medal during the World Cup in Munich in 2009. He also placed fourth in Sydney last year during the World Cup. He placed fourth in Milan in 2009 during the World Cup as well. Then in sixth place, coming with 561 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Pang Wei. He's 24 years old. He won the silver medal during the World Cup in Munich in 2008. And in fifth place today, coming with 562 points, also representing the People's Republic of China, we have Zhang Tian. He's 30 years old, and he placed seventh during the World Championships in Munich last year. He also won the World Cup gold medal in Milan in 2005, and he placed sixth in Fort Benning last year during the World Cup. And in fourth place today, coming with 563 points, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Dae Myung Lee. He's 22 years old. He won the silver medal during the World Championships last year in Munich. He also won the bronze medal during the Junior World Championships in Zagreb in 2006. And he won the bronze medal in Sydney in 2007 during the World Cup. Please welcome Dae Myung Lee. Then we have in third place, coming with 563 points, your teammate Mauro, Francesco Bruno. He is 32 years old. He placed sixth during the World Cup final in Bangkok in 2008. He also won the gold medal during the World Cup in Munich in 2003. He's a silver medalist during the World Cup in Rio de Janeiro in 2008, and also a bronze medalist during the World Cup in Milan in 2005. In second place today, coming with 566 points, also representing the People's Republic of China, we have Wu Xiao. He's 28 years old, and he placed 14th in Zagreb in 2006 during the World Championships. And in first place today, coming with 567 points, representing Japan, we have Tomoyuki Matsuda. He's 35 years old. He won the gold medal during the World Championships last year in Munich. He also won the silver medal during the World Cup final in Bangkok in 2008. He won the bronze during the World Cup final in Munich last year. And he also is a gold medalist during the World Cup in Munich in 2008. So these are our finalists, Mauro. Yes. What do you have to say?
It will be a very good final, because we have Matsuda that is the best shooter in this moment. He won two world championships, and I think it never happened.
I don't think that ever happened either. That was really amazing. He's really starting off this year as well as he did last year. He just won the gold the other day, and I'm sure that he's...
Yes, he's shooting very, very well. And we have also my teammate Bruno. I hope he can take a quarter place.
That would be great.
Yes. We have Lee. He's also young, but he also won some medals, and he's also a great shooter. Zhang took the quota place some days ago. Pang, I think, is the Olympic winner in 2008 in air pistol.
Let's take a look.
Damir is a Mikic. He's one friend of mine.
He's a funny guy, I'll tell you. He makes me laugh.
Yes, he's also a great shooter. He was shooting behind me today, and he has wonderful shooting.
Yeah.
And also Dikic is very good shooter. He took quarter place in World Championships in air pistol. Let's see what happens.
So we're going to see what happens here. What we have 1 point separating Matsuda from Wu.
Yes.
And then there's 3 points separating Bruno from Wu.
Yeah, I think we will have two different challenge from Matsuda and Wu for the first place. And I think the other one for third place, because in free pistol it's easy to lose some points.
Okay.
And so I think there are six for one place, maybe five or six for one place. It would be very nice.
For one place, and it's going to be a true fight.
I wouldn't be there in this moment.
No.
No.
As I was saying before, the guy to be watching more or less is Matsuda, as he just won the gold medal the other day during the 10-meter air pistol. And it was really emotional. I had a chance to interview him after he won, and he dedicated his gold medal to his country of Japan.
Yes.
And it, you know, with the terrible earthquake that hit there.
Yes.
It was very, I just saw a different side of him. It was very, very emotional.
I spoke with him a little bit to ask how is he, his family. I say he's all okay, and I'm near to Japanese people because they are trying to do all they can, and with their emotion, they don't show their emotions.
No, they don't.
And so I like them, and I hope for all will be okay.
Me too.
In
Me
next
too.
Days.
Yep. Real disaster. So we're going to get this final started now.
Yes. First shot is always a big problem.
A little bit unnerving, say.
Yes.
Let's take a look now at Dikac and Miket. Point two for Dikac, and now waiting for Miketz to shoot, and a 9.6. Back on now to Bruno, 9.1, shaking his head a little bit there.
Yes, a little bit. When it's nine, is always a good shot in free pistol.
Matsuda on our screen. 8.8.
Yeah.
What do you suppose happened there?
8.8. The pistol was not so moving, so maybe he lost a little bit the zone of aiming.
Okay. Let's take a look now at the scores. Matsuda shot an 8.8. Wu, a 7.4. Bruno, a 9.1. Lee, a 9.8. Zhang, a 7.9. Pang, a 9.6, Miketz a 9.6, and Dikac a 10.2. Nice shot there for Dikac.
Yeah.
And at this moment, Matsuda is still holding on to first place by 2.4 tenths of a point. Wu is in second place, and Lee is trying to catch up. He's only 6 tenths of a point behind Wu. Let's focus in now on Pang and Zhang. It's very interesting today. We have three shooters from the People's Republic of China that entered into the final.
Yeah.
Just to go to show you one more time what a strong team that they do have. 9.4 for Pang and a 7.6 for Zhang.
Yeah, the front side was a little bit moving after the shot.
And Miketz a 9.5.
Matsuda.
Let's take a look now. We have Matsuda shot a 9.5. Wu a 9.3. Bruno a 9.5. Lee a 9.4. Zhang a 7.6. Pang a 9.4. Miketz a 9.5. And Dikac a 9.5. Matsuda is still holding on by 2.6 tenths of a point over Wu, who now is in second place, and following him is still Lee, and he just gained a tenth of a point there. He's only down by half a point. And the real fight today, Matt, wouldn't you say it would be for the quota places?
Yeah, when you are shooting and thinking to take quota places, it's not easy.
It's not a good mix, huh?
Yeah, and you have to try to think only to your technique and try to lose your emotion, your feelings. It's not easy,
I'm sure that it isn't.
But
and
it's the only thing that you can try to do.
10.2 for Bruno. Nice
shot. Good
shot. Yeah. 9.7 for Lee.
Yeah.
Tang shot 10.6. That's a great shot there.
Matsuda.
Let's take a look now at the standings. Matsuda.
Yeah, watching a little more tense now.
Yeah, some more tense. People are kind of settling into it.
Yeah, maybe the nervous was is going now.
Okay.
Later.
We have Matsuda, a shot of 10.5, Wu, a 9.8, Bruno, a 10.2, Li, a 9.7, Zhang, a 10.2, Pang, a 10.6, Miketz, a 9.2, and Dikach, a 9.7. With that 10.5 that Matsuda shot, he now has gained some tenths of a point. He's now 3.3 tenths of a point over Wu. And Lee is still in third place by 6 tenths of a point. And he is being followed very closely by your teammate Bruno, who's only 1 tenth of a point behind Lee. Yeah, when we were talking about the quota places before, it's up. There's three men in the final today that can win the two quota places.
Yes.
So that's a real fight between Wu, Bruno, and Pang. So it'll be interesting to see.
Yes, after the first shot of Wu, and they are all close, and it will be a very good final.
Oh, a 6.8 there for Wu. Yeah. So I see him looking at his monitor, looking a little bit... shocked. Matsuda, 10.3.
Great. After this shot, it will be not so easy to gain the quota place.
Well, let's just see what happened here. We had Matsuda shooting a 10.3. Wu, a 6.8. Bruno, a 9.7. Li, a 9.5. Zhang, an 8.1. Pang, 10.1, Miketz, 10.3, and Dikach, 10.0. With that 10.3, Matsuda is still moving up ahead by 4.6 tenths of a point over now Bruno from Italy, who has moved up into second place by 1 tenth of a point over Lee. And Pang now has moved down into fourth place, and he's 7 tenths of a point behind Lee. We're going to be moving on to the fifth shot of this final. Now, how do you feel, Mauro, about the new presentation of the finals?
Yeah, I think for us it's always the same thing, because you have 8 minutes for preparation time, and then you have also other 2 minutes, and I think you can shoot the same, and maybe it's better for TV and for other people that can see you in face when before you're shooting. It's nice.
The 8.6 there for Pang. Matsuda is regrouping.
Yeah, another 7.7 by Wu. Maybe some problems.
Some problems. You're right. Matsuda, who by occupation is a policeman, actually. He just shot a 9.9. Let's take a look now at...
It was a good shot.
Very nice. 9.9 for Matsuda. Wu, a 7.7. We have Bruno, a 9.9. An 8.4 for Li. Zhang, a 9.5. Pang, an 8.6. Miketz, a 9.8. And Dikach, a 9.5. Matsuda still has a 4.6 lead over Bruno. And Lee now has lost some lost his grip a little bit over Bruno. He's now down 1.6 tenths of a point, and Pang is trying to catch up with him. He's only 5 tenths of a point behind Lee. So it was a nice shot by Bruno.
Yes. Yeah. 9.9 is like 10 in the final. When you shot from 9.6 to 10 is in final, I think it's always a good shot.
Okay. Now back on to Lee. Point one for Lee. We have some really great scores on this round. Matsuda shot a 10.1. Wu shot a 10.5. Bruno a 9.7. Lee an 8.1. Zhang an 8.9. Pang a 10.7. Mikat's 7.2, and Dikach a 10.6. So we're seeing some things in the tens now, which is nice to see.
Yeah. Dikach is having a very great final this moment.
Mm-hmm.
Also Matsuda. When you shoot in first position and you can shoot like this, it means that you have very good self-control.
Matsuda now has a 5 points advantage over Bruno, who is holding on to second place. And Pang is now 1.1 tenths of a point behind Bruno. Dikach is in fourth place, and in fifth place we have Lee. Moving on to the seventh shot, here we have the ISSF VIPs, and we saw that the president and vice president both have their wives accompanying them here today, which is nice to see. We have Dikach on the screen. A 9.5 for Dikach. Let's take a look now at Matsuda. This is not the first time that he's taken a moment to...
But he's always to find the way to shot in the second regroup. It means a lot, because usually when you are in final that you regroup, it is not always easy. You see that you can shot 10.5.
Matsuda is just gaining more and more points here. We have him shooting a 10.5. Wu shot a 9.3. Bruno a 9.9. Lee a 10.1. Zhang a 10.2. Pang a 9.1. Mikat 9.6. And Dikach a 9.5. Matsuda is now in the lead by 5.6 tenths of a point over Bruno. And in third place now we have Pang, who is 1.9 tenths of a point behind Bruno. Dikach is in fourth place, and he's 1.1 tenths of a point behind Pang. And tied up, he's also tied up with Lee, so things are going to change around. We still have 3 more shots of this final. Let's focus in now on Francesco Bruno. A 9.4.
It's okay.
Mm-hmm. And Dikach has just shot a 9.3.
Stop and load.
Matsuda, 10.2.
It looks as if Matsuda is untouchable today. After shooting a 10.2, he has a 6.4 tenth of an advantage.
He's
now.
He's shooting like air pistol.
Wu shot a 9.9. Bruno a 9.4. Lee a 9.5. Zhang a 9.2. Pang a 7.6. Miketz, an 8.6, and Dikach, a 9.3. As I said before, Matsuda has a 6.4 tenths of a point advantage over Bruno, and Lee is now in third place, and he is behind Bruno by 2.9 tenths of a point.
In third place, 2.9 points behind second. Dikach remains in fourth place, 0.2 points behind third.
For your next competition shot, close.
And it's interesting because we have Pang and Wu now tied up, so the fight for the quota place is another whole scoring that we're doing.
Yeah.
Two more shots to determine who's going to be on the podium today. It pretty much has it wrapped up. Matsuda has it wrapped up the highest lead unless something drastically wrong happens. A 10.3 there for Lee.
Great shot for Bruno. For all, almost all.
A 10.7 for Pang. And Bruno had shot a 10.5.
Yeah.
What do you suppose is going through his mind right now?
This is the final of Francesco. He likes to shoot in final, and he has a lot of experience.
Mm-hmm.
And he can shoot very good in these situations.
Wonderful. Matsuda, 9.3.
After shot nine.
So let's take a look here. Matsuda shot a 9.3. Also, Wu shot a 9.3. Bruno, as you were saying before, a great 10.5. Lee, a 10.3. Zhang, a 10.5. Pang, a very admirable 10.7. Miketz, 10.4. And Dikach, an 8.8. Matsuda with that 9.3, lost a couple tenths of the point, but it's not going to affect his standings by any means. He's still ahead by 5.2 tenths of a point. Bruno is holding on to second place and a quota place at this point by a good 3.1 tenths of a point. Lee has now moved up into third place, and he is in third place by 4 tenths of a point over Pang. And this is the fight really for... Wait a second here. Wu is now down in sixth place. So it looks as if perhaps Pang and Bruno will be going home with the quota places. It all depends on this last shot.
Yeah. The most important shot.
A 9.5 for Pang. Matsuda, a 7.9.
But it's enough. That's for Francesco.
This is great for Francesco, and let's take a look now at 7.6 for Dikach. Let's take a look at the scoreboard now. We do have Matsuda as the gold medalist by 4.2 tenths of a point. He hit a 7.9 on his last shot, but it was had plenty of room for error, let's say. Your teammate, Francesco Bruno, has won the silver medal and a quota place, and Pang has won the other quota place and the bronze medal. Here we have... Tomoyuki Matsuda, gold medalist on our screen right now. This is the second gold that he's won this week. He is just really on a roll, I have to say. Let's take a look if we can find... there he is. Francesco Bruno from Italy. You can tell he's quite pleased with that win, huh?
Yeah.
And he rightfully should be.
I'm very happy for you.
And let's see now if we can take a look here at Pang Wei. And there he is, a bronze medalist and an Olympic Games quota place holder for the People's Republic of China. Mauro, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. It was really nice to have your expert. Thank you. Your expertise in this field. And I wish you the best of luck in Korea. We'll see you there. Okay?
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Bye.
Bye-bye.